I thought this was a dying breed. I thought we got rid of Bayonetta. I thought this was extinct. I thought it was like the dinosaurs, just couldn't get past the Ice Age, but apparently not. They are here, they're alive, and they're thriving. Yeah.
All right, so getting to this game number one, Aaron versus Lima matchup. I'm only gonna say this once, because I know people hate it. A matchup we saw a lot in Smash 4.
And Diddy what?
games in far, far past. Diddy Kong, one of the few characters who was able to box with Bayonetta's just oppressive hitboxes and options as she's landing in a combo game. Because once that banana's in hand, one of the few who can just cover the forced RCO lag that Bayonetta has from doing so many specials.
Yeah, and get a hard punish as well from it. Not a lot of characters are able to get a smash attack, but Diddy can. Toss the banana, get a free smash attack, easy peasy. Now, one thing, though, that has not changed is that recovery. Nice. Which is getting exploited right now. You need one more hit, not able to find the mark. Lima gets back on stage and bold, overzealous, and you're paying for it dearly. You reach, I teach. Don't make that type of mistake versus Lima.
Yeah, up tilt back air. That up tilt has a very big hitbox and a very high percentage can confirm into a back air, which, as we saw before, is brutal from Bayonetta. So Lima, known for that walking up tilt usage, I've seen them play many a times and get a lot of mileage off of that. And oh, going for the jugular. Lima trying to shut this out early, send Aaron down final stock, but Aaron able to stay alive for now. But looking a little bit lost in how to deal with this pressure. And I like how Lima's not really going for too many long extended combos. He's going for the low profile ones, just the 1-2 tit for tat to make sure that Aaron doesn't get those big punishes. Aaron's saying, I don't need it though. Give him that back air and give him the kill there.
Absolutely. And one thing to note is that we have not seen Witch Time use yet. So that's something Lima still has on the table. And you got to imagine Lima is just waiting until it's needed to just Witch Time something really small and just take an entire stock possibly off of Aaron.
Oh, and the Smash Bros. Platform actually throwing off Aaron's punish there, being forced to land on that rather than drop through and get that banana toss into a punish there.
Look at the hopscotch playing around. Good forward air from Aaron. Unfortunately, Lima able to retaliate.
Right. Getting some multi-hits in there.
Trying to catch the side B, actually.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, really smart stuff by Lima. Did not work out, but I love the thought process. Also, good job by Aaron, kind of being really disciplined and not just throwing out the side B.
Yeah, that time, though, now he's throwing it out when it counts, able to get the banana in there. All right, and not going for the big punish there, just getting a grab and going back for the banana. And looking for the angel drop.
So
almost
close.
Got it. Almost got it.
So close. Woo. Scary, and just Aaron throwing in these side beats, it's just really good times, knowing that Lima
connecting.
Goodbye.
Yeah, I thought that wouldn't quite connect, but that second hit, just having a big enough hitbox. And I'm noticing that monkey flips are coming through when Lima gets to the center stage and hides on their platform. A lot of people in Smashville like to hide under the platform and hold shield, knowing that like you can't really drop in on them because that platform's there. So Aaron's saying,
especially as Bayonetta, because you're up, be out of shield is so potent anyway. One of the few jabs in the game that can kill. Rapid jab for damage, killing blow as well. Bowser Jr. Bayonetta definitely had a nice quality of life change in this game.
Yes, sir. Yeah, a huge change. That was actually pretty needed because at those higher percents, it can get kind of difficult if you can't land that up tilt back air confirmed.
And Lima right now not looking for an up tilt back air confirmed, just looking for damage. And they get a little bit. 36, not too bad. Oh, it is continuing. Almost taking the lead off it as well. Actually doing just that.
Yeah, Aaron having some great DI on these down tilts and these small combo starters, though.
Down tilt, down smash. I don't know if that was real.
It's real enough, but that's looking pretty
get him
damn
out.
Real. That's looking real. The damage, the knockback, that's real. And Bayonetta, Lima taking game number one. They're so synonymous in my head, I actually switched them up. Lima,
there were
a mistake.
Only two. There were only two smash attacks thrown out, I believe, by Lima that entire set. One was the down air, down smash attempt to try to go for a spike, and the other one was this crucial forward smash. And one major thing people don't talk about in this game is that Bayonetta's smash attacks no longer have projectile priority. These are true smash attacks. These are actually disjointed now.
And they be hitting.
Oh, does it?
Yes,
does
sir.
It?
Here comes a giant fist.
Out of another dimension. You know what? I think Aaron might be in that dimension now as well.
Yep. Say hi to Madam Butterfly for me, man. All right, so here we go. Getting into game number two. Lima looking strong. Starting off solid.
Yeah, but it's weird because Lima kind of snuck that one away. Aaron had the lead. Aaron was playing well and just... I don't know, Lima got one hit and just did not let off the pedal.
Yeah, that's what Bayonetta does. I mean, those one hits lead up to many, partially by design, but when you have a player that's experienced as Lima, it gets even more dire to fight against.
Down air as well, the bullets. just Lima, just everything is going his way at the moment.
Oh, almost getting the forward air. That would have killed, but we keep it going all day. All right, so Aaron, let's see how he can make this recovery. Going to get hit.
Oh, genius.
Oh, nice.
Aaron still made it back.
Yeah, I think he actually jumped and started charging his upbeat. Have a little bit of insurance there in case they came through. So able to survive the weather storm a little bit longer. The recovery from Aaron looking great. When it comes to getting damage, looking a little bit lost. His defensive wall, great.
And you're talking about insurance. Aaron needs a new company.
Yeah.
Okay, it is not working. Lima's at 37% reading, teaching, writing scripts, and Aaron is just along for the ride.
All right, but now it's finally Aaron's turn to play. Let's see what kind of damage he can get out of this. Just opting to fade back over the banana. I think this might be a bit of a herald to some earlier habits against Bayonetta when the character has been more dominant in previous games, where going back to the banana was just the smarter thing to do. But in this game, oh, almost getting the witch time on the banana. But in this game, I mean, you kind of have to get in there when the opportunity does arise itself, because Aaron fighting way from behind at the moment. So let's see what kind of damage he can get here off the sled trap scenario. Oh, missing the Z drop. Tapping out on a lot of ledge pressure right there in Lima. It's just free reign to ABK right back to the stage.
Yeah. And, I mean, you were saying, what is Aaron going to do? I do think you wait with the banana, maybe. Try not to take too many risks. This could be big.
Yeah, yeah, nice.
Nice.
The thing I like about that is, catch the DI slipping as well. Because by the time you get by the third down tilt, it's like, all right, let me just hold out and not eat another. Uh-oh. It's Bayonetta, what am
yeah,
I saying?
Nothing too wild.
What are we saying?
I mean, the only way Aaron would have to go in for, like, a double spike, like a down air to down air. That was the only way of getting that. Probably was not going to happen. But Aaron, you know, definitely a lot more evasive right now. Not taking nearly as many risks, not being nearly as committal. Seems to be giving Lima some issues.
Yeah, and getting more mileage out of those hits as well. I like when Diddy's go for that neutral air, because at mid to low percents, you get a good follow-up. And it's always about the positioning for Diddy. When your opponent's way up above you, you have free range to set up the stage however you want. Lima not giving a chance right now, though. Had the right positioning, but didn't anticipate the kick coming through. Aaron mixing things up beautifully. And the forward smash, I'm really surprised that tripped. It looked like Lima was still high up above the stage.
Bayonetta is big.
Yeah.
Always on the ground.
She's like 7.5 feet tall canonically, dude. She's huge. That's a tall
and
woman.
Wears heels.
Yeah, and wears heels. That's confidence.
Like, if you thought I wasn't looking down on you, okay?
Yeah.
But, I mean, Aaron definitely turning things around. Still not out of the woods quite yet. You're at 142. You got to imagine the up tilt back air will take it.
That was so smart. And we're still out there, though. Lima using all the resources to go deep for the edge guard. And whoa.
That almost worked.
All right, but Aaron's turn to play, getting a big confirm off that banana into down air. We can eat those. We're at 198. You know, any damage now, as long as it doesn't kill, it doesn't matter. That matters,
dash
though.
Attack. Really surprised that was the option Lima chose, but it did work.
Ooh. Parry off the taunt, too. I mean, this could be a subversion of taunt to get body right now, because Lima taunted a couple times to get himself back into it. Dropping really low on that recovery, going to drop even lower for that stock. Aaron, bringing us to an even game, 1-1 apiece. All right, let's go, let's go. I love it when these games get close, man. All right, so I'm wondering what the counterpick is going to be. Honestly, like, the counterpick, it might be town and city unless it's banned, because, like, those close side blast zones do matter a lot, and those platforms can assist in combos and help trap down Diddy Kong a bit more. Sure, Diddy has a bit more free reign to run around, run about, run amok even, but I think the risk-reward might end up in their favor, and yep, town and city is the pick for this game number three here. A very important game, a break point even. Whoever wins this, going to be a set point. Moving on through loser bracket. So let's see what we got. Characters staying the same. Matchup staying the same. So Aaron starting things off a little bit slow. One of the nice things about the spawn points in Town City for Diddy Kong is that you just have so much time to get the banana and just, you know, wait. Get one of Diddy's win conditions in hand. So let's see what Lima can do. Getting with the Witch Twist out of shield. Being a bit more liberal on the Witch Twist usage, I'm just noticing early on. Maybe trying to set up for just Aaron to think a little bit more as the protect gets higher on. But oh no, getting the down throw, going to be sent off stage. But Bayonetta going to be just fine, opting to recover high, not giving Aaron an opportunity to ledge trap right here, Logic.
Yes. You know, I wonder how Town and City is going to play a role here. If the Final Destination kind of layout is going to help Aaron, hurt Aaron, is Lima going to be able to get better juggles because of it and really just stop Aaron from landing? I'm curious. And the platforms. Also something to note, because it's going to allow Lima to kind of wait Just stay out there and wait to react to what Aaron does to try to recover.
Yep. Hang out there, keep it slow, and as you said, oh, gets the forward throw. Is that going to be enough? No. Lima taunting a little bit early, but, I mean, still in a good position until I jinxed it. Aaron looking for a back air. Lima able to fight back, though. Looking to use the gun, but Diddy Kong is such a small character. Once he gets his feet on the ground, he'll be able to run up in there and get some free stage control. Oh, using bats within, but I feel that before I left the moon. And getting the read on the air dodge as well. Lima, the options are getting checked down. Aaron looking very confident. But up till the back air should do. Oh, yeah, especially off the top. Going to explode right there.
And really, really even right now. The banana not playing as much of a role as I was expecting, surprisingly. Like, Aaron has great use of it. But it's really Aaron's kind of combo game that's helping Aaron out this match.
Yeah, I'm thinking he doesn't want to leave it out too liberally because of the witch time. If like Aaron is close enough to pressure, which he wants to be, witch time on a grounded banana will be enough to probably lose him a stock, let's be honest. So,
yeah.
Gonna want to keep tight control over that right there.
Nice little nair into the up air. No meaningful damage. All right, banana coming into play there. Not big damage, but definitely putting Lima in a poor position because now you have to worry about recovering against a Diddy. Getting off that ledge when there's banana, there's down tilts, there's forward airs, there's back airs. So many things that Aaron can throw, but apparently just AB kick through.
Yeah, so sneaky right there by Lima to find his way back up in there. So I'm looking. I mean, Aaron hasn't used popgun a lot, but I know heel slide does go underneath that. So, I mean, Aaron using all the right options at the right time, because if Diddy gets too complacent in any aspect of the set, it can easily fly over to the side of Lima.
Yes. And you don't want a Bayonetta to have a lead.
Oh, never, never.
Guns might start blazing.
Yes, they will. And looks like they're starting to get warmed up and revved up at the moment. But Aaron's like, excuse me, coming through. Excuse me, ma'am.
Yeah. Ooh.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Ankle down, these hands. F-tilt, yeah. I think everyone forgot about that option. That wasn't even a two frame. That was a just caught you lacking.
Yes, sir. These F-tilt, super underdeveloped move, I believe. Oh, Aaron opted to take the hit and keep his jump, but going so low, hitting the tech. Still smart stuff, but Limo's like, okay, even if you hit the tech, that back air will be enough to cover.
Levels.
Yeah, I think it will cover tech jump, and because Bayonetta's back air hitbox is so big, we'll even cover neutral tech there.
Oh, Lima thinking there was going to be a high recovery from Aaron. Aaron clearly hip to it, though, and recovering low, which is more risky, which is why Lima wasn't ready to cover it.
Yeah, I'm loving Aaron's recoveries, both in game one and here, going high, going low, using every option that Diddy Kong does have. So let's see how he can potentially get the stock away. Has enough stage control to get the banana going. And not even using it at the time. Using the Z-drop and using the nair. Keeping the aerials on deck there. And, oh, this could be huge. Going to get up throw into the up air on Town City. Not going to be enough, but resets with the banana. Ooh, that trick did. So close.
Go around. Oh, no!
No! Whoa. Not like that. Bayonetta, baby. The witch is alive. The witch hunts are not over. That was peak Bayonetta. The bats within.
Yo. That's, oh my gosh, that's a tilter. That's a tilter.
Oh.
That's a set winner right there.
Oh
that's
my gosh,
within?
Let's see that again. Trading with the forward smash the first time.
That's already the tilter and you're like, it's okay. It's not the end of the, wait a minute.
Oh,
did
no.
I really just,
it
did
was
I
at that
really
moment.
Just.
It was at that moment he knew he actually did nothing wrong on 99% of the cast. But on Bayonetta and Mithra, gotta keep that air tight. And at a hair's breadth, Lima taking game number three right there. The break point now sitting at set point here at Super Smash Con Fall Fest. And guys, I don't know who's going to take this. All right, so game number four here. Aaron fighting for his life. And when he's back to his corner, I've seen Aaron play with Mensa level strategies. I mean, at Summit just last month, or not last month, time's weird in COVID, man. Just a couple months ago, Aaron defeating Tweak in pools, and that was the best I've ever seen him play. Best I've seen almost any Diddy Kong play. So if he can tap into that again, I won't count him out. But Lima, though, as I said before, these Bayonettas, they travel in packs, and they get a buff when they're all together. Right now, dead even, only 0.5% severing these two players, and I think in the 11th hour here, Diddy with banana in hand is who I want to bet on, Logic.
I wanted to, but I don't know. These demon hands keep coming out. And two forward smashes have been the game winners for Lima. And the fact that you got that off twice, I don't know. I'm a little scared for Aaron.
That's true. on not getting the up smash. Maybe recognizing that it wouldn't have been true, trying not to get batched and just getting that dash attack to get some more space in there. That time, though, yep, no down tilt needed. Awful whiff jab as well. Lima, I saw some like hand motion there being like, bro, what was that? But even still, gonna be able to recapture some of that pressure there. Aaron gets the banana back, though. This should be a re-grab. But honestly, punching banana re-grab can be pretty tricky on most gas. Diddy's one of the few that can do it, but even still, there's a risk that has to be taken there. Because if that witch twist pokes above the ledge, especially the first one, she's facing the other way, you could be in a bad position again.
Great side B coming in from Aaron there. And just, oh,
should do it.
Gone you are. I mean, you still have a great advantage. You're still up by quite a bit. You can't let your foot down. You know, you gotta still kind of be safe. Take it easy because you know that Bayonet attacks on so much damage, which, ooh, okay.
Nice interrupt.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was about to say
that. Equalizer.
Mm-hmm. But yeah, for Aaron, as you said, this is really just one Bayonetta combo away from being an even game. Potentially even a stock loss. Kick so deadly, and this is how it starts. Heel slide, one of the combo starters, but another interrupt. Maybe it's her box shifting on the neutral air right there, but yeah. When did Lima even get that banana, actually?
Lima was pushing buttons. Banana was in the way.
Yeah.
Lima said, give me that too. Oh, really early on that forward smash, and dying for it. Aaron, so intelligent right there. After the second down tilt, knowing the percent, knowing how Lima was going to DI and saying, you know what? Let me wait, let me react. Thank you, Lima, for the air dodge. But he's firing right back with that forward smash.
But another thing is that Lima was looking for a bats within there. That's a frame trap that works specifically for Bayonetta because once you hit that down tilt to up smash again, that conditioning's in their brain. It's like, okay, I can bats this next time. But next time, there might not be an up smash to bats. It'll just punish that air dodge instead.
Yeah.
Aaron playing on all pistons right now.
Good throw. Are we going to go for the edge guard, though, or are we going to just stay on stage and maintain control?
Oh, using the end hit of the ABK, a near fixed knockback is going to put Aaron just far enough away to get the kill.
Beautiful. And just even the slight delay on deciding when to go out there, I think, made it more difficult for Aaron to recover.
Yeah, both of them playing on, I mean, so beautifully. And that banana coming down for an assist, giving Aaron a bit more damage, which he desperately needed. You do not want to give Bayonetta a chance. Once you get above 70%, things get in just a bad position, and I think after this string, we're going to be sitting at that golden percent. Not quite yet, though. Still going to be safe from some of the pressure of Lima. This is where it gets bad, though. This is where it gets awful.
I don't think you're dead.
Yeah,
you're
going
to take a lot of damage, though. Definitely launch her. Oh, no!
What a read!
We thought you weren't dead.
We thought. He thought, too. What
Yo.
A read!
Yo, I don't think anyone saw that coming.
We were out of our chairs. Out of our chairs. I saw that fist rise up. I rose up too. It was like, on God?
I popped off harder than Lima for that one.
Yeah. Lima's like, yeah, I knew. But meanwhile, I was like, holy.
I mean, the reads have been on deck and just like the awareness and just the chess game being played by Lima. I was talking about the witch time, which never came into play.
Yeah.
But forward smash, up smash. Those were how all three games that Lima won. How he won, how he finished it. And just, again, I was talking earlier about how the smash attacks now, they're not projectile priority. They're real disjoints.
Mm-hmm.
And that was a beautiful demonstration of it. You like to side B out. You like to get out of dodge. No one can beat your kick except for this disjoint right here. To the heavens you go. Goodbye, little monkey.
Yep. And